In this video, I'm going to teach you how to control your arm on the robot, as we've already built one in one of our videos. And the first thing I'm going to do is go to blocks and create a new op mode and call it first global arm control. And I'm going to hit OK. Now I'm going to initialize our motors. And so the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm actually going to set our mode. And so I'm gonna go to left arm dot mode to stop and reset encoder, and right arm dot mode to stop and reset encoder. And then I'm going to set our arms to run to position. And essentially what I'm doing here is I am resetting our encoders on our motors, so that's the rotation sensor, and then I'm setting their mode to run to position. Run to position is essentially where you give the motor a position to go, and it's going to go to that position as well as it's going to hold its position. So the arm's not going to start falling down as gradually. It's going to keep its position, and this is generally the best way to control your arm. And so now the next thing I have to do is I have to actually reverse one of our arm motors. So I'm going to set left arm dot direction to reverse. Okay, and the last thing I have to do is I'm going to create a variable called arm position, and this is the position that we're going to be assigning to our arm. And so I'm going to set arm position to 0. Okay, now our initialization is done. I am going to start, or sorry, I forgot one thing. We have to set the powers of the arms to 0. So I'm going to set left arm to 0 and right arm dot power to 0. Okay, now our initialization is finished, so I'm going to start our op mode. And in here, what I'm going to do is I'm first going to set the powers of both arms to 1. And so left arm. And then I'm going to set both arms' target position, so this is the position that we want them to go to arm position. So here we go. And the last thing we have to do is we have to change the arm position. So we go to variables and change arm position by, and I'm going to use the gamepad 1 dot left stick Y. Okay, now this code should work, but I'm going to teach you about another cool thing that First Global has gives to us, and this is called telemetry. And what telemetry allows you to do is give text output to your drivers, and so, and this is when the little black box at the bottom of your tablet where there is sometimes text. And how you use this is you go to utilities, telemetry, and then you call telemetry.add data, and then I'm going to add data arm position, and then I'm going to actually just put the arm position variable. So this is going to tell you what the arm position is. And then every time you call telemetry.update, it's going to update that text. So I'm going to save this op mode and I'm going to show this to you. Okay, here you can see that I have first global arm control selected, and I'm just going to hit init and play. And there's our robot. And as I move the left stick, it moves. And so one thing you can see is also as I move our left stick, that telemetry value right there, which is a little hard to see in this video, is changing as the arm position is changing as I'm moving. And so this allows you to see what your arm position is. And so one thing that's cool about run to position is if I decide to try to push the arm, it's going to hold its position. It's going to apply power to hold its position.